Hi everybody, it's Saturday. I am actually doing a video on Saturday, so that's good. My husband just left with my kid. They went to the park. I went ahead and made breakfast this morning. I made plenty of eggs and bacon and sausage, and I even made pancakes. And so now my kitchen is coincidentally full of dirty dishes, and my house is a big old mess and stinks of butter and burnt pancakes. And my husband said, let me get out of here before any kind of cleaning is required of me. So yeah, he's gone. Yes, I made breakfast. Yes, I binged on the breakfast. Yes, I perched on the breakfast. I ate pancakes also, which was completely horrible. Fuck my life. The fucking pancakes try to kill me. And they tasted bad because, like, my husband, he went to the store and got butter and syrup. And he didn't get butter. He got margarine and gross. And you just can't make pancakes with margarine. And then he got syrup and he didn't get the right syrup. He got, like, the syrup that was like light or fat free or sugar free or some shit, and my god, that ruined my pancake experience. So, but it doesn't matter because I rarely taste food anyway nowadays when I fucking binge on it. Everything is just shovel it in your mouth and get it out of you quickly enough. So, oh my goodness, folks, yesterday was just pure insanity. Oh my god, yesterday I was in bed practically the whole day because I was having horrible heart palpitations. I had the worst migraine ever, and every time I got up and walked around, I swear to god I was gonna fall on my ass. So I don't know, my god, you know what it was? It was because I took a diet pill, and now there's some strange noise emitting from my kitchen. Why does these things always happen when I'm fucking by myself in the house? Okay, now, you know the routine. If there's something behind me, you let me know. So, anyways, okay, now, matter of fact, I'm going to take a diet pill again today. I always tell myself, after I take the last diet pill, you're not going to take any more diet pills because the diet pill is going to give you a heart attack. And that's exactly what it feels like. My god, my heart was beating so fast yesterday, and I would just put my hand on my chest and it was just like fucking a ticker, and then I would put my hand on my chest again, and then I couldn't hear it anymore, and I was just like, oh my god, I'm turning into a zombie. So and I was just so cold, and it is cold. It's cold today outside. It's like 70 degrees. Yesterday was 60. It's 70 now, but to me it feels like 40 or something because I'm just always cold. But anyways, I keep telling myself I'm not going to take the diet pill, and yet I'm taking it again. So, god, yesterday the diet pill had me completely non-functioning. I had to, but I didn't binge and purge. It was like 7 o'clock at night, and I still hadn't binge and purged. That's the one thing that I like about the diet pill, that it kind of holds me off a little bit from doing that. So, that's the only downside to the shit. Now, I couldn't take it anymore, so what I did was I made something to binge on, like something just light or whatever, and then I perched in the bathroom and I felt fantastic. The headache, everything, the anxiety, the heart palpitations, everything just went away. That's the one thing I hate about the binge and purge cycle, is that sometimes you could be feeling at your worst and then you'll cave and then you feel like nothing, and then that's the mentality, and then that's how you keep going and going, and next thing you know it's tomorrow and you completely wasted the day doing that nonsense. So I think that the reason why the diet pill affected me so badly was because yesterday I took my medication. I took my my depression medication. I didn't take the Buspar, the anxiety one, because since Buspar is to take away anxiety, and then the diet pill actually gives you anxiety. Like, I don't know the collaboration of those two things. Like, who will win that battle? I don't know. So, that's why I don't take the Buspar with the diet pill. I went ahead and took the Wellbutrin with it, and I think that's what it was that had that awful effect on me. But today I'm not going to take any kind of medication, any kind of vitamins. I'm just going to take the diet pill and probably some laxatives at night and see what happens. So, wish me luck that I'm still going to be here. So anyways, finally, after I purged, I managed to work out. It was a semi-okay workout. And then I took a shower and got drunk. Yesterday I was all by my lonesome because my sister has been really depressed lately, and she's like, oh, I don't know why I'm so depressed. Hello, you have an eating disorder. Yeah, those things depress you. Your serotonin levels are not the same, especially if you're binging and purging. So I was trying to get a hold of her. She was nowhere to be found, and so I had to be by myself. The boy, my sweet, sweet boy, was working all day yesterday. Yesterday was Veterans Day, and so they were really, really swamped and busy at his store because they were giving away free sandwiches. And so the poor thing, especially that store he works at, they like fucking slave drivers. They put only two people to work the whole damn store and shit. So the poor guy. But anyways, he got home exhausted and then tried his best to stay up as long as he could and hang with me. And finally, I had to tell him to go to bed, you know, because he was just so tired. I'm like, listen, you know, and he didn't want to go to sleep. He like felt guilty and stuff too. No, I don't want to go. And I was like, listen, it's not like you're sitting on your ass playing with your balls all day. You are working, you know, you're actually doing something. So I can totally understand if you don't want to talk, if you are tired, you know, that's perfectly understandable. Go ahead, go your butt to bed. I will be here tomorrow and we'll talk again. It's not a problem. Finally, I had to put him to night and he went to sleep. So yeah, so I started drinking. I went ahead and got on Twitter and Facebook. My kid went to bed at 10 p.m. yesterday, and she actually put her own self to bed. She got on the computer, was playing, was on YouTube, and then it was 10 o'clock at night, and she just put herself to bed. And it's sad because it's the weekend, and you're supposed to be up and stuff. But the sad truth was that yesterday was going on 6 o'clock in the morning, right? Everyone is asleep, and to myself, I'm thinking, because I'm already awake at 6, because I have, like, this internal clock that wakes me up to work out, and so I'm thinking to myself, okay, we including the cats. Like, if the cats make noise, I'll get something and I'll fling them at them. Like, shut the fuck up. We'll have to sleep in today because I love to sleep in the morning when I can. But my daughter will wake up early. But yesterday it looked like she was actually going to sleep in. Oh, so I was excited. I'm like, good, I'm going to get to sleep in until like 10 maybe. And so 6 a.m., oh my God, the cunt that lives across this fucking hall from me started screaming at her crackhead boyfriend, and screaming in the hallway. Then her kid started crying. Then she started screaming at her kid, yanking her kid every kind of way, yanking her kid from the arm. My God, she's gonna pop that arm out the socket. And I don't understand how people are parents. I don't understand these shit bum parents that are out there. Some people don't need to breathe. They don't need to spread their seed anywhere. This stupid person doesn't deserve to be a mother. I'm so sick to death of these fucking bum, deadbeat shit parents out there that have their kid up at all hours of the night, or fucking beat their kid because their kid is hungry or the kid is crying, or like they just have complete disregard for a child. They just don't know how to raise a child. They don't have the fucking brain capacity for it. And so that's that dumbass over there. But I'm sick of those people in general. All you motherfuckers need to be lined up in a row, and they need to shoot you in the fucking head, okay? Because my God. So you'd have to excuse me, I'm still on my period. But anyways, asshole across the damn hall woke my kid up. So it's 6:30 a.m. and fucking my kid is up already. So that's probably why she took her butt to bed at 10 o'clock at night, because she was just tired. Long day. So anyways, I was on Twitter. I was on Facebook. I was on Twitter. I love Twitter. Twitter is the friendliest place out there. Everyone's on Twitter. It's just so helpful and friendly. And the thing I love about Twitter is that you can actually address your haters. I have a hater. Yes, I have a hater. I have this hater, and she doesn't like me. That's okay, because I don't like you either, motherfucker. And I like Twitter because I can address her. And but she's off talk. She's full of shit. She reminds me of like this big, dumb, fat dog that kind of is like, woo, and barking all the time. And then like one day you just get fed up and you turn around and you address the dog. And what does the dog do? Well, the dog that's all bark, obviously, backs up, puts his tail between his legs, and just runs away. So yeah, that's that fat bitch. But anyway, she hates on me. I don't give a fuck, bitch. You wanna hate on me, let's do this. We fucking can use Twitter as the avenue. I have no problem. Come on. So but anyways, besides that cunt on the computer, I had a good time on Twitter and Facebook last night. I was chatting with a bunch of anorexic boys. My guys, like, they came out of the woodwork. I love my Anna boys. God, they're just so friendly, and they're just so, it's just so sad sometimes, hearing some of them, like, get so down on themselves, you know, because they don't need to, you know, and, but I had a good time with the majority of them last night. A few, you know, Ed girls here and there too, of course, but, But yeah, it was like Anna night. It was just a bunch of Anna boys just popping out of nowhere and talking to me. So I made a bunch of new friends last night, and some old ones that I had there. So I had a good time. I was drinking. I finished the whole wine bottle. I was thinking about opening up another wine bottle, but something had stopped me. And so, oh, by the way, look at that. I have 6 of these. Yeah. So this is also contributing to the hyperness. I feel really manic today. So I was having a good time all by myself on the computer. Now, my husband gets out of work. He sees that I'm up. He starts working out, watching TV. He goes ahead and starts with the whiskey, fixing himself a drink. Oh my God, whiskey. I knew where this was going. Oh God, so I'm already like, okay, let's see now, any second. But he actually left me alone. He's been leaving me alone lately these days, with the exception of looking at me like he wants to eat me for dinner sometimes, but that's about it. So I'm already talking to, you know, getting ready to log off. I'm already saying goodbye to the friends and everybody. And so he gets in his bed and he gets under the covers, and then I'm already logging off the computer and just, you know, deleting history and all that stuff. And so my husband just completely flips out on me. He just completely goes insane. He is like, oh my God, that's it. Who the fuck are you talking to? Who are you talking to? You're talking to that boy, aren't you? And I'm like, what the hell? Where did this come from? And then he's like, that's it. We have to talk about this because I want to know who is that guy in all these pictures. Who you gonna go up there and you're gonna go fuck somebody? You're gonna let somebody go fuck you? And I was just like, oh my God, this motherfucker's tripping. And so I got pissed because I was in a good mood and I was not gonna let him ruin my mood. I said, no, this is not gonna happen. I have pictures of the boy on my iPod because, you know, I chat with him, and so he sometimes sends me pictures and I'll save them on there, and then I'll put them on the computer later or something, or, and also on my computer, but my husband doesn't know how to get on here and look at them or whatever, but he, obviously, they're clearly visible in the iPod, so, and he has erased the boy's file with the pictures on it more than once already, so, but I back it up, so I put it back on there, but anyways. I can have those pictures if I want on there. I want to look at the boy any time of day. I can have those pictures there. Those are my pictures, and that's my iPod. And so this motherfucker started tripping. And so I logged off of the computer, put the computer away. I'm like, listen, okay, enough. I am so fucking tired of this shit. You're not going to talk to me any kind of way. I am done with you talking to me like this. I'm going to go up there. I'm going to have a good time. We've had this conversation 1,000 times already. You keep acting like this is the first time. You keep acting like a fucking Alzheimer patient. Like, I have to keep reminding you that your life has changed, you know? This, my God. I have to keep reminding you that we're not together, that I'm going to be with another man, that in January you're leaving, that I'm done with you, that this marriage is over, that I am not in love with you, that I don't want to have sex with you, that I don't want you touching me. I have to keep telling him over and over and over. I swear to God, he's bipolar or he has hints of Alzheimer's or some shit. So I tell this goddamn bastard, I'm like, listen, enough the fuck up already. That's enough. Enough. That's it. I'm tired of you talking to me like this. I'm gonna go do whatever I want. You had an affair. You got to do whatever you want. You got to fuck around with some stupid waitress. You got to have your say. You got to have your peace. You got to have your fun. You bust a nut in her as many times as you wanted to. Like, you were untouchable for months. That's it. Don't forget that you had an affair. You know, I have the right to do whatever the fuck I want. Number one, because we're not together. And number two, because I can do whatever the fuck I want to do. And, if I want to give this pussy away to whoever, I can fucking give it to whoever. And that's it. I don't belong to nobody. I ain't got no motherfucking boyfriend. I ain't got no man. I could do whatever the fuck I want. Okay? That's it. He got so quiet that he zipped his big mouth and got back in the bed and went to sleep and left me the fuck alone. This morning I got up, I started making breakfast, I started clanking the pans and the pots, and I'm just like, yeah, yeah, yeah. He got up, he just apologized profusely, and he blamed everything on the whiskey as usual. I was like, listen, it's not the alcohol, it's you. You're the problem. You keep blaming the alcohol. You know something? It's everything you say when you're drunk is the truth, regardless. This is a universal fact, okay? you keep blaming the alcohol. It's not the alcohol. This is how you genuinely feel. I don't care. I'm just done, and I'm tired of you talking to me like that. I'm done with these personal attacks. You talk to me like I'm this giant whore who just goes out every night and fucks any kind of guy, or is on drugs, or leaves my kid while I go do God knows what. I have no friends. I have no life. I don't do anything because you've manipulated my life so much that everyone's gone because they're sick and tired of waiting for me to fucking smart up. So the next time you talk to me any kind of way, I swear to fucking Christ, I am going to get that goddamn bottle of roach spray, and I'm just going to spray the shit out of your ass. And he's just like, oh my God. I'm like, yes, I'm going to spray you in the face with roach spray, because that's what you do when a fucking insect is just pestering the shit out of you. That's what you do. You spray him with the roach spray. So he was just like in shock, like, oh my God. So yeah, that's why he's not here. He's like, let me get the fuck out of here before she actually uses the roach spray on me. So like, yeah, but I'm sorry for all the profanities and the vulgarities. I'm still on my period. And I'm upset that I'm still on my period. Oh, hello, what the fuck is going on down there? You need to go away, because next week we got things to do. But anyways, yeah, so I'm going to take my diaper, I'm going to clean my house, and I have to go get my daughter her suitcase. I found a cute one. And just start getting stuff ready for next weekend, you know, because I'm so forgetful. And now I have to overpack like a bunch of stuff because my sister is like, got me worried now. And I have to pack everything I own now. So, yeah. So I'm going to talk to you guys again tomorrow. Hopefully this video is not fucking a long half-hour video again. I'm sorry if it is. I hope you're all well. We'll talk again tomorrow. And have a happy Saturday. Goodbye.